Welcome to day four of...
Where are we?
Sports Cap.
Are you sure?
I'm not sure.
I was kind of hoping I was at the beach.
You're day four of Sports Camp. She'll change the name to Awesome Camp because that's what it's been. God has been so faithful and, you know, giving us great weather. Just so excited to really just have this last day out here before we go back to the church.
Today we're going to talk about, in order to go the distance, you must know that you cannot do it alone, okay? You cannot do it alone. Let's all say that together. You cannot do it alone. Very good. I'm very good. And today we're going to hear a Bible story about a man named
Paul.
Very good. We're going to talk about Paul. Okay, we're going to continue to talk about Paul.
I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Now there is in store for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day. But not only to me, but also to all who long for his appearing.
Which found?
2 Timothy 4.
All right, so the main point of this week at Sports Camp is that though God is with us all the time, we really need him to play sports and to keep up our energy and to rest and do everything in life. And we've learned that lesson from Paul this week, and it's been really awesome. And not only have we learned about Paul, but we've learned how to play basketball and some great skills for that game.
Our kids are Kaylee and Aiden playing soccer. It's been, the whole week has been great for them. They love it. They actually go to the planes, so they get a lot of camp. So I really love it. The whole week has been great.
Right now, we've just got done with our first sports session, and we're just relaxing. All the kids are out and about at their huddle times, sharing their coaches, their assistant coaches for the week are sharing a story with them today about how they can't do it alone, because that's our theme for today, is how we can't do it alone. We need God to be with us in all we do.
It's Oreos and banana night.
Minute to win it, that is hard to do. You must be good at it.
Come on.
You're done, Luke.
I'm done.
You're done, man.
Flip it. He's got the King of Hearts, all right? And so he's going to be Paul in our story today, because Paul stood before King Agrippa and Queen Bernice, and he had to tell his story, all right? So you'll hear about that in Bible time.
Yes, tomorrow evening I have the privilege, it's a blessing, to be able to give the gospel message to these kids. So I just pray, anybody watching this, pray for us that their hearts would be touched with this message of John 3:16, and that we just close this wonderful week in the correct manner for God.